Yo, what it do, y'all? It's your man Mike Titan, the gaming savant. Today we playing some My Team NBA 2K16 Road to the Playoffs. And yes, I'm finally back on the My Team. It's been a while. This is my second game, I believe. I still got the same lineup pretty much. I added Tariq Black because he has really good offensive rebounding, and that's what I wanted for my power forward. Valanciunas is going to be my main scorer on offense, and then Black is going to be my cleanup guy to kind of get the rebound. We still haven't unlocked enough cards yet to design my court and stuff, so hopefully I'll be able to get to that before around the time I record my next video. So this guy I'm playing right here, he has John Lucas at point guard, and he pretty much just tried to dribble with the point guard, and 3 seconds on him, so we get the ball right there. Now, mind y'all, I'm still trying to get back into the grooves of playing 2K. I'm not going to say at this moment it's my favorite game to play, but I do still enjoy it. As we throw the ball to Hamilton right here off the screen for the three, and he misses for some reason because he's probably a freaking bronze, even though he has like 85 three-pointer, and I put corner specialist on him. He's dribbling right here with Quincy Acey back to the top of the key, over to the left, and apparently Quincy Acey is the new LeBron James because he just made that over Valanciunas, even though Quincy Acey has the offense of Reggie Evans. And if y'all know who Reggie Evans is, you know that all that dude is good for is rebounds and the occasional block. As Valanciunas misses the post shot right there, we got Black back to Pierre Jackson with the three. And this man Pierre Jackson, a lot of places that I've read have been telling me that Pierre Jackson is probably the best bronze point guard that you can get, as he shoots the three with Quincy Acey. What the fuck is wrong with him? Pierre Jackson, in my opinion, is the best bronze point guard. Why? Because he has like an 81-3, very good defensive stats. I believe he has like a high steal or something like that. He's very good, as you will see in this gameplay, as we are up 5-4, get the jump ball right there, cut ahead in the gameplay a little bit. Now I'm down 8-5. Jackson bringing the ball up the court, dribble it down, passing it over here to Black. I think I'm trying to run a play. I'm not 100% sure. Black passing it over to Valanciunas, and it gets tipped, and that was killing me this game, all the turnovers. As he throws it on the fast break, scores again, and now I'm down by 5 points. And I'm just trying to figure out, I'm really beating myself. Like, the turnovers just was killing me. Throw it to Valanciunas, dribbles by him and dunks it down with one hand. Please get out my way, Quincy Acey. You not LeBron James, son. You more like some sorry small forward who is Black. That's name I can't think of right now. Running the pick play right here with Jackson, passing it over here to my man Hamilton. Are we gonna try this three again? And we gonna miss it. Now, Hamilton does pretty well later on in this video. Just right now, I don't know. I don't know if I'm getting a shot release wrong. I don't know if because it's online that, and he shoots a three with Quincy, and he made the mother, wow. Quincy Acey, people. Quincy Acey. Maybe I should give me a Quincy Acey. I didn't know the nigga could shoot threes. But we throw it over here to Hamilton, and he finally makes that mid-range jumper wide open on the side, up 21-19. 3 minutes left in the second quarter. He's dribbling down the court, and what he was trying to do was literally just do this. So I played off-ball defense because Pierre Jackson, I don't know. I'm still not a fan of the on-ball defense in this game. 24-24 right now, under a minute left in the second quarter. Pierre Jackson with the crossover and the rainbow three in your face. Don't let the GOAT get wide open, because he can shoot threes. Like, he can shoot threes. So please don't leave him wide open, because he will make it rain, splash, waterfall, all types of wet innuendos about raining. And he has his own Pierre Jackson as well, and he's trying to dribble, and like I said, this is pretty much all that he did the whole game, just try to manually dribble and get by my defender. And luckily we had help right there. He pushed a forced shot and misses it. And Jordan Hamilton, what the fuck are you doing, dude? What are you doing? We had the rebound. There was no need for you to try to do the over the back thing. We had the rebound. So he gets another free, I just had a brain fart. I'm not going to edit this out. Possession. He just had another free possession off that turnover. Jackson goes to the basket, passes back to Quincy Acey, and he ain't making two threes in a row. Hell no, 2K, please don't do me like that. So we dribble it right here with Pierre Jackson. Hold the ball up because we want to take the last shot of the quarter. Pass it over here too. I don't know who that was, but we're going to pass it back out to my man Jackson, and he going to make the clutch three as time expires. give me a 30-24 lead at halftime. That man, Pierre Jackson's a beast, man. I'm telling y'all. If y'all play my team, y'all still in the qualifying rounds, y'all need a bronze point guard, get that man. Matter of fact, keep him. He may even be a good backup point guard to have on your team, as we missed that corner three right there, and he dribbles back up the court with John Lucas trying to get by my defender, just turboing up the court, dribbling right here with Lucas trying to get by my defender. I'm trying to play help defense when he goes by. He shoots a bad shot, and it goes in. Contested bad shot with John Lucas. Like I said, I don't know. Maybe his team had the LeBron clutch gene, because these dudes were just making every contested layup. And I'm dribbling right here trying to find somebody open because he's playing off-ball man defense. Dribbling right here on the side. I believe that is Markel Brown. Passing it over to Hamilton for three. There you go, Hamilton. About time you made something of yourself. Jordan Hamilton, he's all right. He's a three-point shooter. Markel Brown is more of a dunker, but he can shoot threes if he's wide open. Like I said, Tariq Black is an offensive rebounder, and Valanciunas is my main low post scorer. So I'm trying to play help defense over here, and he throws up a bad shot. I just wait for him to shoot. Get the rebound with Valanciunas. Run up the court with Pierre Jackson trying to find somebody open on the break. He has his big man switched on me, so I dribble by him. Pass it back out to Val. I don't know why you were at the three-point line, Valanciunas. That's not where you need to be. Posting him up right here with the spin move and dunk it down for the domination. Valanciunas, man. Very good silver. I wanted a big man for silver because I want a low post scoring, because you can get like 3-point scoring and everything at a bronze players, but low post scoring is very hard to find in a bronze power forward or center. They're all usually suck ass. We pass it back here, pass it back around to Hamilton for the mid-range shot, and we get it to go. Good ball movement. I believe that gives us a 10-point lead if I saw correctly, and apparently my opponent could not handle the lead, because as soon as this timeout gets started, he pulls the plug. He's had enough. He's like, I'm done. I'm tired of Pierre Jackson balling on me. I'm tired of Jordan Hamilton swishing threes in my face. I'm tired of Valanciunas dunking on my defense. And he quits the game. So that's going to be it for today's video. I want to thank you guys for watching. Please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. It's your man, Mike Titan. And I'm out this piece. Gone.